Hello everyone and welcome to our first video in the series. In today's video, we are going to start building our UI. At the first part, we are going to build this UI. I've already covered basic UI building in our previous video. If you haven't seen that, check that out in the cards. So let's start by building this. At the base, we have our scaffold. At the first element over here, we have our app bar. To the app bar, we have a title and the actions. In the action, we have only icon button. Moving to the body, you can see that all the elements are vertically aligned. So you have guessed it right. We are going to use a column. In the column, we have first element as a text button. So this is a text button. On click on this, we are going to show a date picker. Let's go back. In the second element, we have our list view. So in the list view, we have dismissible cards, that is dismissible widget. Inside that, we are going to have a card. And inside that, we are going to have a list type. In the list style, this is our title and these are the subtitles. So in the subtitles, we have used a column again. In the left, we have a leading, which is an icon button again. And to the right, we have an icon. Moving to the floating action button. This is just a floating action button with an icon as a child. So let's start building. Over here, I've already created a project and made a screen over here. So let's start. So as you can see, we need a scaffold over here first. Let's start building by a scaffold and then an app bar. So let's start with an app bar first. App bar, we have title over here as my to-do app. So let's do this. Yeah. And to the right, we have actions over here. So let's make an actions tab. In the actions, we need to have an icon button. And the icon would be icon.exit to app. Yeah. And this also requires an onPressed event. Let's add that as well. Yeah. So basically we have done with the app bar. Let's go to the body. In the body, we are going to have an colon. Yeah. So the first element over here is our text button. For the time being, I'm going to add just a text named date. Later, we are going to change that. And this also requires an onPressed. Let's give it this. Yeah. And for the later part, we have a list view. So let's make a list view builder. And we should also add a shrink wrap property. As we are using this list view builder inside our column, so we need to add this property so that the list view don't overflow in the column. Let's add an item count of 3. I will just return a container over here for the time being. Yeah. For the next part, we have our floating action button. Let's add a child property and the icon. Icons.add. That's it. And this also requires an onPressed. Yeah. Okay, let's try and run this. As you can see that we have our app bar and the floating action button ready. Now we can start working on our list view builder. So let's start by adding our dismissible child. Okay, it requires a child. Let's give it a card. And it also requires a key. So key needs to be a different value for each child. So we are going to use a value key. So let's give it an indexed. Yeah. The child of the card would be child. This child. Yeah. And for the title, we can add a text. Text title. Yep. Yeah. You can see that we have our dismissible ready. Let's add some padding to it. Padding. Cons. Edge inserts all. Let's give it as a 10. This looks good. Now we can go to our card again. Let's add a background to the dismissal bill as well. So the background would be container. It will have a colored property. So let's add a red color. Colors.red. You can see that we have a red color over here. We also want an icon to the left side of this. So let's add a child property. Child icon icons dot delete. Yeah. Let's see. You can see that the icon is in the center. So we need to also align it. So let's give it an alignment. Alignment dot left center. Center left. Yeah. This is more to the left side. So let's give it a padding as well. Wrap it inside a padding. Yeah, this looks much better. The size of the dismissible is greater than the card size because the card also provides a margin. So we can remove that margin from the card by margin const as inside solve 0, 0. Yeah, so this removes the margin. And now we need to add some padding to the dismissible as well. So let's add that. Yeah, this looks better now. Yeah. So let's go to the card again. So we need to add a subtitle over here. That subtitle would be a column again. Okay. So we can add a text here. The text is, so this is our description, DESC. So the next would be a date again. So let's give it a text for now. Date. Yeah. Okay, now we need to also align this. So the cross axis alignment dot start. Yep, this looks much better. Let's also add in leading icon. So the icon was our icons dot check. Yep, check circle outline rounded. I guess this was the icon. Yeah, and we also need to add an onPressed event over here again. Yeah, this works. And for the trailing part, we need to add an icon over here. So this is icons dot arrow forward. iOS. Yes. Okay, as we are done with our list view builder, so we can start working on our buttons. Also, I told you earlier, we need to give a date picker. So first we need to also format our date. For the formatting part, we are going to add a dependency in the PubSecYAML. So this dependency is intl. So this gives us a date format class. We can use that to format our dates. So let's start building this. Date format, we are going to provide a custom format for this. So DD. And if you want to know all the format types, I will link that in the description. You can see that by yourself. Dot format. And for the time being, we are going to provide the date time now to see that it is working properly. And then parse it to string. This is working properly. So first of all, we are going to make a variable over here. That is date time. That is the date equals to date time dot now. Yep. Okay, we can replace this by our date variable. Okay, we can start building our date picker. So let's make a method over here, date picker. Yeah. Okay, I'm also going to create a final variable with today's date. Today equals to date time dot now. Yeah. And also we are going to get our selected date in our variable again, final selected date. Okay, we need to await for the date, add async modifier, and we are going to call a function from our material package, that is showDatePicker. Yep. This requires an initial date, which is the initially selected date. So we are going to pass our variable to this. The next is context. The context which is provided by our stateful widget. And now we are going to give it a first date. This is starting range of the date, which is selectable in our date picker. So let's give it a date time. Yep. And the year would be 2020, the worst year. And the 11, and first date. Yeah. So this goes by like year, month, and the day. So the next parameter is the last date. This is the parameter which says the last date of the selectable range. This is going to be dynamic, so the user can select the date ranging in the next year as well. So let's give it a today dot year plus one, and the today's month. Yep, and the today's date. Yes. So yes, we are pretty much done over here. So we are going to check that if the selected date is not null, so that the user have selected the date, and selected date is not equal to the current selected date. Yeah, so if this is not the case, then we can change the date over here. So date equals to selected date. Yeah. So we are done over here. We can pass this to the on pressed in our date button. Date picker. Yeah. So we are done over here. If you click on this, you will get a date picker. And you can click on the date, select a date, and click OK. So this changes our date. So this is working. If you like the video, please hit the like button and share it with your friends who are interested in Flutter. And please subscribe to the channel if you don't want to miss any future videos from us.